This video is sponsored by iSkySoft. Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace Aleya from toleratedcinematics.com, and today it's another Motion Graphics Monday. Today we're going to see what we saw in last week's tutorial, but last week we saw how to do that in Premiere Pro, so now we're going to see how to do that in Adobe After Effects. We're going to see how to create this awesome ride-on effect, which is really cool for travel videos and vlogs and stuff like that, music videos and whatsoever. A lot of people really enjoyed last week's tutorial, but they wanted to know how to do it in After Effects. I actually chose to make it in Premiere because a lot of people don't know how to use After Effects or don't have After Effects, but it's actually easier in Adobe After Effects because it's a dedicated software on title design and stuff like that. So without further ado, let's jump into Adobe After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and as you can see right here is my video file of Altea. So this is a location I went to on vacation, and yeah, beautiful beach. Okay, so what I want to do is actually drag this video into a new composition right here in Adobe After Effects. So now I created a new composition. We'll make it a little bit larger so we can actually see what we're doing here. And now two things we can do. So the first thing we need to do is, of course, add a text. We want to add a text to our title. By the way, a little while back, I made a video on how to make your titles pop, and it's a really interesting video. If you haven't seen that, I highly recommend you to check it out. It really makes you understand how to make your titles pop in videos, because sometimes you don't have enough contrast within your video, and therefore your title gets a little bit lost there, and that's actually really a bad thing. So definitely check that video if you haven't already. Yeah, let's see how to do that. We'll go to our text tool and click right over here, and I will just write the location, which is Altea, like this. I will Control A to select all my text and actually make it a little bit bigger, like so. And there we go. And now I'm going to choose the font Gloss and Bloom, which is a very cool font for this type of effect. Of course, currently right here in the character, I still have my caps, all caps selected. I will uncheck that so we have a cap letter here, and then the small letters after that. Okay, so I'm going to double click here and change the font color from red to white, because I prefer the white simplistic color, and also center this out, so zero this value out. This actually spaces your text here. I don't need that for this kind of effect. And there we go. So now we will go to the Align tab right here, and if you don't see that, you can always go to Window Align, or click on it, and then select, well, or click on this icon, and that will center your text perfectly in your scene here. So that's a very simple and quick trick to center your text. So go to your text tool, well, your selection tool right here, and click away. So now we have a text on top of our video. We want to add a little detail below our text, like we did in last week's tutorial. We added a kind of brush below our title, which makes it a little bit more personal, a little bit more like a design element instead of just a plain text. And as I said also, we're working on a new brush pack, and it's not out yet. We're working hard on finishing it, but you can use it in all kinds of videos. It's a really cool style, a really kind of grungy kind of street style, which works extremely well in travel videos. So I'm going to import that. Before we continue this video, I would like to talk about Filmora Video Editor. Filmora is an amazing full-feature video editor that is just less complicated than a professional end software. And if you are a beginner or just someone that does this as a hobby and wants to create amazing travel videos, vlogs, or anything like that, I would definitely advise you to check out Filmora, download the free trial, all the features as a full feature video editing software, but it's extremely easy to use. And if you don't want to put all the complexity into it, it comes with pre-installed templates and stuff like that, which is ideal for someone that just wants to enjoy the video editing process without too much headaches. So be sure to check it out. Link is in the description. And now let's continue with the tutorial. All right, so here we have the brush pack. We have the splatter elements and the brush elements. I'm going to open up the brush elements and just choose the same one that we chose last week. So the 77, I really enjoy this one. It looks very cool. I'm going to import that and just drag it onto, into my composition right here, maybe below the text just to be sure. And then go to the rotation tool right here and just rotate it. And also make it what the selection tool, maybe a little bit slimmer like we also did. And then with the rotation tool, drag it over to the bottom here. And as you can see, everything goes a little bit smoother and faster in Adobe After Effects than in Premiere. It's a lot of like clumsiness in Premiere to make titles. I really love making titles in Adobe After Effects instead of Premiere. Premiere is my editing platform. They're really trying to improve the title design features, but After Effects is still the hero and the master in this kind of area. And that's why we're actually making templates in Adobe After Effects and changing them into essential graphics, which you can then use in Adobe Premiere Pro. All of that you can see on our website if you want to. We'll continue here with the color correction and we'll add a fill effect to our black brush and change it to a white brush, and there we'll click OK. There we go. So now we have a nice brush element right here. Okay, very cool. So we have our title. Maybe we want to select our title and our image and actually drag it up a little bit so it's a little bit more centered. And then we can go for a simple layer precompose, and we'll precompose this as our title. Click OK. So now we'll go to our pen tool and just quickly zoom in here, and it's a lot easier than in Premiere. We can just click here and draw around our text like so. So very easily we're going to draw a mask like we would be actually writing our text. So we're just going around everything, and if you have clicked something, you can hold the space bar to reposition while you're actually still selecting. Okay, and then we go back down, and right here we're going to draw the T. Okay, and then we're going over here, click over here and make that T, kind of line here. And then go down and start into the E. And as you can see, it's a lot easier than in Premiere. In Premiere, you have to do frame by frame kind of animation, and it's, yeah, a lot of clumsiness in my opinion. And I would never do this in Premiere because I'm an experienced After Effects user, but some people just don't have After Effects or don't know how to work with After Effects, and therefore I made that tutorial. But if you're an After Effects dude, come on, make your titles in After Effects, seriously. Come on, it's not that hard. Okay, so go back to the beginning here with this line, and then we'll go into this line and finish it, okay. Great, so now we have our mask, and what we want to do is click on our title, and we want to search for a different kind of effect this time. We want to search for the stroke effect in the effects and presets. So stroke, and there we have the generate stroke. We're going to apply that to our title composition right here, and immediately it's going to select that mask that we just draw on our on our image, but you can also just select the mask if you want to. And you can also change the color to a red color, so we can really carefully see the line of the text structure. So now we can increase our brush size until the text is actually covered. Okay, so apparently I didn't really connect the last mask here with the previous mask, so what I'll do is quickly go in here and just continue this mask. It's also possible that this is a little bit too thick, so what we can do is just return once to be sure that everything is covered here. And make it a little bit thicker until we don't see our text anymore. And right here we can actually see that our text isn't completely covered. So what I'll do is select this little button and then just increase it in size a little bit, and then just increase it just a touch more and refine everything until you don't see your text coming through anymore. Right here we still see it as well. Maybe change it to 45, and now our text should be completely covered. Okay, perfect. So now we have our text. What we'll do is just go to the paint style here and change it to reveal the original image. So there we go, we have our original image back because it's completely covered by our mask. And we want to go to the beginning of our timeline, change our end to 0, click on the stopwatch for the end, and then go like 3 seconds. And change it to 100, and if you're going to preview this, immediately we're going to have a write-on effect. Okay, so this tutorial, I really discussed everything and I went slowly on this process, but as you can see, you can literally create this effect in 1 minute. So you can open it up through Premiere Pro, open your video file, replace it with an After Effects composition, get into After Effects quickly, draw your title, draw your mask, and you have your title. So I would prefer doing these kind of things in Adobe After Effects. And right here we actually see a few other mistakes that our brush is actually coming through here. So we can also fix that very easily like this by bringing it up a little bit. Of course, it's completely up to you how much time you're going to take on creating this. You can also speed it up a little bit to kind of fix the errors you see in your text animation. Right now it's kind of slow. We can actually go by clicking U on the keyboard, selecting the keyframe and bringing it closer a little bit, and that's going to write it on a little bit faster and kind of fix all the blemishes. We can also maybe feather it a little bit. So go to the brush hardness and set it to 0, or actually let's say 50. And there we go. Alright, so that's how to do this effect in Adobe After Effects. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a like. Also, subscribe to the channel for more. I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.